Tonight's Eye on America is about a football team that's undefeated, and not just on the field. Marshall University is headed for next week's Motor City Bowl in Michigan. CBS's Jim Axelrod reports it's the climax of a championship season for Marshall and the culmination of an incredible journey that took nearly 30 years.
In this locker room in Huntington, West Virginia, a college football team is praying for a comeback. And the game hasn't even started. In the nation, Marshall University is playing for its conference championship and a bowl game bid. Former player Nate Ruffin thought he'd never see the day.
All right, way to go!
0-27 by the time I got here. We had not won a game in 27 games. We were...
Nate, that's lousy.
That was terrible.
It got worse. After Nate arrived in the late 60s, Marshall was cited for recruiting violations and kicked out of its own conference. Winless and hopeless, they couldn't catch a break.
And from whence this program came,
yes,
is probably a lower point than any other program in college football.
Any other. No doubt about it.
Just when you'd think it couldn't get any worse for Marshall, it did. November 14th, 1970, the team charter was returning home from yet another loss. Flying through the fog and rain, the plane crashed just short of the runway. All 75 on board were killed. Coaches, boosters, 37 Marshall University football players, gone.
The bodies were home right with the aircraft.
It remains the nation's worst sports disaster ever. Just hours after this game was played, every player in white was dead. Every Marshall player but three who were injured and didn't make the trip. One was co-captain Nate Ruffin.
I identified one of my former roommates because I knew the chain that he wore.
It would take him 5 years to shake the nightmares, even longer to beat the drugs he took to forget. Nate Ruffin was plagued by survivor's guilt.
If I hadn't got hurt, I could have been there, and what could I have done? I always think, what could I have done to cause the plane crash not to happen?
Marshall is experiencing her saddest hour.
In West Virginia, it will always be known simply as the crash.
Bottom line is, we lost everything.
Jason Starkey, like so many who suit up for Marshall now, plays for two teams.
No one wants to forget because that's a piece of our history. And as sad as it may be, you have a sense of pride that you're carrying out something that they'd be very happy about, that they are very happy about. And I'm speaking of the 75 members that went down the plane crash.
And on this night, Marshall will need some inspiration.
He's hit and dropped!
Down 20-0 at the half, the championship.
Yeah, he's in there!
The bowl game bid.
Touchdown!
The undefeated season. They're all slipping away.
It ain't easy, but nothing worth having is easy.
But when you've started from ashes and come back this far, what's another few touchdowns? In a finish more Hollywood than Huntington, Marshall scores 34 second-half points.
Touchdown!
And wins on a last-second touchdown, almost like someone was watching.
There's 75 guys up there in heaven.
And what do you think they're thinking up there?
They're smiling and crying just like I am. God bless them.
All these players, when they finish Marshall, one of the things they will remember, my 1999 team was great, but let's remember one thing. There was a 1970 team from which I came.
Sometimes in America, we make too much of sports. It's not exactly life and death. Everybody knows that. Except maybe the folks at Marshall University. For Eye on America, I'm Jim Axelrod in Huntington, West Virginia.